What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Evelyn E, and it's that time again for the Change Report. That's right. That's right. It's time for the Change Report. I'm really, really excited. So, this week's topic is, do you remember where you were when COVID came amongst us? Boom! COVID! It's time for a change. I do. And in fact, I was in a train and was working with some amazing youth and we made this shirt which says be kind and I'm cool and be inspired. And yeah, it was definitely at work. And when we found out that COVID was truly impacting our work lives, we had to make a lot of significant pivots. And so not only have a lot of people across this country, children, had to shift because of COVID, but we also had to figure out what is going to be the best way to navigate those waters. Right? What are those change skills that we need to have just in order to make it through? And that's the thing that I want to encourage you to think about. What has COVID done to your routine? We've definitely had to do a change up, right? From things that we were so used to doing regularly, from going to the gym, going to church, going to work, going to fellowship and hang out with friends. We couldn't do that anymore. We had to stop all the things that we loved doing. I have a little puppy and she liked to go out and play and do things. She couldn't do it no more because of COVID. And they didn't make the little puppy masks because I couldn't put on her puppy mask for her. And so what does that mean? That meant that I too had to figure out how do I navigate this world. COVID has really caused us to make those shifts and those pivots. Why? Because our health is super important. And how has that impacted us, right? So I really had to take a chance to look at myself and how I've personally been impacted by COVID. And I encourage you to definitely, definitely do the same. As much as we had to make these shifts, it's been so important that as long as I'm making sure I'm staying safe, I also know that it's so important to shift up our routine a little bit. I can't keep doing the same thing, right? It's so important that even though we may be stuck at home, how can we work within our house, right, to make sure we're not only working from home, because we gotta work from home, we gotta sleep from home, we gotta teach these kids from home. I don't have any, but I know some of y'all do. You gotta teach these kids from home. And how do you have and hold on to that balance? And so that's the one thing that as you think about the change up, you think about that, make sure you're doing all you can to change it up, but not to say, like, y'all remember that movie? That was a really good movie. And that's what it kind of felt like, right? You wake up and say, think about it. We got to change our routine, right? And so one of the things that I really work to do is look at how I can make those changes so that I don't get stuck into a slump, stuck into a sadness, stuck into things. How can I make sure I'm out there being kind while at the same time being Evelyn and doing social distancing and all that good stuff, right? One of the things that I work on to realize is how has this quarantine, how has social distancing really work to impact me, right? And so I had to do some self-reflection on how has it impacted my character, right? As I work to navigate the world, as much as I want to believe that everything's gonna be okay, I have to be patient with that, right? And it's really challenging me to look within myself. You remain calm, you remain cool. So hopefully y'all can take that nugget and work that for yourself. Also, what has the change in our environment done for my health? I had to really, really work to incorporate exercise into my routine. As much as I changed it up, as much as I knew I couldn't go outside, I really had to work to make sure I was putting that into my routine. That was so, so important for my health. And then I had to make sure that I remained and have a good attitude because this sucked. I hated being at home all the time and couldn't do nothing. But what was that attitude going to get me, right? So I had to work to make sure I remained and have a positive attitude. Because I know your attitude impacts your character. You see how that looks together, y'all? Okay. And then as I continue on, as I continue to work through and navigate these waters that's been really, really challenging, to say the least, at times, I really had to work on what it's going to be. What am I going to do once COVID is under control, if you will? What's going to be that narrative? What am I going to say from the start of COVID to the end of COVID? What have I done to make sure I become well-rounded? What is going to be my narrative of Evelyn? So I encourage you to think about that. We still have time because COVID ain't going nowhere. Continue to work on what are you going to be on the other side of this? What is that narrative going to be? Because what? There's always that opportunity for growth. There's always that opportunity for improvement. I really worked that into my routine to make sure I didn't want to be doing the same thing I was doing in the beginning at the end. So hopefully I saw some growth within myself, and I hope you do the same. And then finally, that environment, right? As we shift to put things in our environment to change up our routine, we want to make sure that it's a healthy, connected, loving environment. Because not only are we loving ourselves, we're sending the love off into the world. So hopefully you enjoyed that. Hopefully you shaken up your routine. Until next time, I'm your girl, Evelyn E.